Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about asexual and sexual reproduction. Let us first define a few key terms. Reproduction is the production of a new organism of the same species to ensure the continuity of a species. Asexual reproduction is the production of genetically identical offsprings from one parent without the fusion of gametes through cell division involving mitosis. Sexual reproduction is the production of genetically dissimilar offsprings from two parents with the fusion of nuclei of two gametes, a sperm and ovum, to form a zygote. Now, let's compare the difference between asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is carried out through cell division, binary fission, spores, vegetative reproduction, and artificial propagation. Whereas sexual reproduction is carried out through production of gametes by reproductive organs in animals or plants. Asexual reproduction involves one parent, whereas sexual reproduction involves two parents. There is no need for sex cells in asexual reproduction. But in sexual reproduction, there is a need for male and female sex cells, each being a haploid gamete. There is no formation of zygote in asexual reproduction. But a zygote is formed during fertilization in sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, only mitosis is involved. But in sexual reproduction, besides mitosis for growth, meiosis is required for the production of gametes. The offsprings are genetically identical in asexual reproduction. But the offsprings are genetically dissimilar in sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, there is rapid replication during favorable condition and the population increases rapidly. Whereas in sexual reproduction, it takes a long time for fertilization and the population increases gradually. Asexual reproduction can occur in plants and simple organisms. Sexual reproduction can occur in plants and more complex organisms. Finally, we will look at some of the advantages and disadvantages of asexual reproduction. One advantage of asexual reproduction is that only one parent organism is required. Another advantage of asexual reproduction is that it is a relatively certain method of reproduction and reproduction is rapid. As the parent is well adapted to a particular habitat, the genetically identical offspring would be suited to the environment as well. Lastly, asexual reproduction requires less energy as there is no need to grow reproductive organs to produce gametes and search for a mate. The disadvantages of asexual reproduction are as follows. There is a lack of variation in offsprings which prevent evolution. Adverse conditions and diseases will likely affect all members of the population, resulting in the whole population being possibly wiped out. The distribution of the species is likely to be limited to certain area due to genetic variability in habitat adaptations. Lastly, there might be overcrowding and competition for resources such as water, nutrients, light and space, especially for plants which remain rooted. That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.